Hello. Hi. I'm Patricia McNeely. I'm an illumined Blu-ray twin flame from Chicago, Illinois. I hope you're doing well today. Today, what I want to talk to you about is not the solstice, not the full moon we're having, although that's affecting a lot of people, but the new moon coming up. This new moon in July, of course, we will be past some people's Independence Day, approaching some other group's Independence Day, and it is all about being independent and sovereign. But it's weird. Once again, it's weird, but it's not really bad. And some things will still be like blessings in disguise. So this new moon that's coming up here in July is actually going to have an effect that I'm calling the drop down. Okay. Now, if some of you have ever, you know, watched that old cartoon, maybe not so old, but maybe your kids like it, Finding Nemo, where they had the drop off, okay? This is the drop down, okay? It will be affecting organs. It's going to affect several organs, mostly in the upper body, although some people may still feel this in their knees, particularly their left knee, left foot, left ankle. You yourself may be feeling it. Now, when I went through this, and my higher self makes sure I go through things so that I'm very thorough and I know what's what, and that I know how to present, and not only that, I know how to teach people to get themselves through it, but not only that, to empower themselves. So this is going to affect organs. And it will lead people to feeling extreme exhaustion. For some of you, you're maybe on that advanced part of feeling some of this extreme exhaustion. And it's not fun because you still have responsibilities. Or you're feeling a brain fog and you're feeling mentally scattered along with the exhaustion. You need to keep putting one foot in front of the other. And you're not sure how you're going to do it or what exactly it means. But there are reasons for it. You are needing to keep going. And the direction you're going to is to health and TLC, tender loving care. Okay, so this is an energy where it is informing you as well. This is not just something happening to you or another one of those smackdowns like you see in wrestling, like, woo, gonna smack you down. You just got the smackdown. Ooh, Bert, look, he got smacked down. It's not just that, okay? In fact, you're not all the way down. You're actually a little bit higher vibe than you might realize right now. Although it feels weird, right? It feels weird. Kind of feels like you're not merely making progress before something just gut kicks you and then what? And you say, now what? Now what? Or worse, you do the blame game and you say, what is that person on the other side doing to me? Okay, don't go there. Don't go there. Because that other person is actually embodying the parts of you that you want to put together. And you will be put together and you will be actively and proactively putting yourselves together. And not as a fragment, not as fragments or broken people, as healed people, as whole. You're as whole as a half a being can be, some of you. So how do you keep going to health? The other thing you're going to find is strictures. Okay, what does this word mean? This means this. Things are tightening, okay? Some parts of you are just needing to tighten. You might feel it actually around here where you're saying, oh my goodness, I don't think it can get any tighter. I can't breathe. I can't function like this. I can't catch a breath. I can't catch a break. I don't know how I'm going to keep going. I have responsibilities. I know that. I get you. I had to go through this when I still had to get up, still had to drive, still had to function, work, do some things. And for some of you, there are no sick days. There are no sick days. But you're not feeling well. You're not feeling 100%. And it's different. It's a different type of purge. It's not something where you can just vomit and it's out. It took me a good month. It took a good month of being proactive about it. Even while I was upset, because some of this is upsetting. So let me just tie this in for you. Because while it does baffle the mind, particularly that part of your ego, which is connected to a mind or connected to a collective, which does want answers. Those answers won't come from the human level per se, from everyone. I have the answers, but the reasons actually go out to the cosmos. So this goes to some of the astronomy, the astrology. Okay, the places you've been, the timelines you've been in, you're at an ending point. So the solstice was a closure. Things that you started in 2016 are not only coming to be brought full circle, but they are coming to a closure, a conclusion, and a finality, like a final ending. That's it. And it's being cut off. So what do you do about this? And where's the silver lining in all of this? What is the thing that you really are expecting to come out of this? Well, these strictures have to do with your financial well-being. It has to do with your health and your emotional well-being. Now, with the emotional does go mental, spiritual, and your sense of your own self as a higher being and your twin as a higher being. This is having a healthy union and having healthy relationships. And just to dispel some of the myths out there that are floating around, you have one person who can embody the other parts of you. Everyone else is just not. Okay, so it doesn't matter what name you call it. And some people do go seek help. This is, you know, sometimes how it starts for people. Even your twin, they might say, what's going on? I need to work with someone who knows about, like, I don't know, spiritual stuff. They consult their priest. The priest can only go so far because it's limited. They consult a psychic. And there are psychics who are twin flames themselves and don't believe in it. Or believe it's a concept. Because until it happens to that person, they won't really know it. It has to be a twin flame, like me. And it has to be someone who is here to teach and empower people and get you leaping forward. Okay, not just walking forward, because sometimes you might feel like you're only making baby steps. Let's get you to leap forward. Because the drop down is happening for a reason. It is happening for a reason. Here's another thing. Having your partner with you. Everything would be much easier if only. Okay. Now, for the majority of people, it's not happening like that right away. As much as you wish, want, cajole, argue, or become angry or blame about the other person not being at your side to see you through everything, it's sometimes not happening in that way, the way that your mind and your emotional body would like to. And if you're seeking other partners, that sometimes doesn't work either. Why? Because the human side will fail you at times. We've all failed each other. That's a part of being human. We cannot be superhuman unless we are the angelic being that we truly are. So your superpowers lie in your connections to who you are as a human angel and an angelic being. So the next thing is, you are actually coming into new lives. So I have a webinar about that. Jumping into new lives, new timelines. And some of you are seeing this. And I'm just going to tell you another thing. Not only does this affect your organs, this will affect not only the amount of sleep that you get, how you sleep, the quality of your sleep, and the quality of your dreams. I do dream interpretation to help people to move past things. There's no need to confront people in your physical life, but there are ways to get things moved and shifted in a much more amicable, agreeable way. I know how to help you with that. I know how to help you with your organs. I have been through this. I have died 1,000 deaths to be here at this point. In fact, I was making a joke about it to say, people would say, how are you? Well, I'm much better now that I've died 1,000 deaths. Now that I can breathe and now that everything's not tightening and seizing up, because it feels like that. You can feel like a car that's driving along until the engine seizes up. And then what happens when things seize up? You stop. You stop. You have to pop the hood and see what's wrong with the engine or see what's wrong with the parts. What caused the problem? I already know that. I already know how this is affecting people, what to do about it, what supplementation to take, what movements, what channels to get open. And I will be doing that as a 4-week class, which I'm calling the Lionsgate webinar. Lionsgate webinar, new moon to new moon. This is intended to carry you from July's new moon period, up just past the actual Lionsgate. Why? Because that one's a biggie, folks. That one's a biggie. And why else? Because you're not just 144,000. That's another myth out there. The 144,000, why do you think that's in ancient scriptures? It's not happening now. It already happened. That's maybe how many people could get off the ground. You are one in a million. There's a million of you. Million of you worldwide. Now, some people don't know what hit them. Some people don't know what's happening to them. And they're going around seeking advice, sometimes from very well-intentioned people, but who know nothing about twin flames or the twin flame journey. Are you on a twin flame journey? Some people are taking a retreat into the land of Egypt and denial. Denial. You're saying, no, I'm going to be over here on the river of the Nile and deny everything. I'm not a twin. I don't buy this. It was crap. Okay. Here's the difference, though. Your body is still going to, because the natural parts of you want to be natural again. It's that simple. And I had a very good reminder of this. I had a reminder on a trip I made recently. I was actually in Mexico, and I was it was sort of like a work trip there. I was doing some work, and there were several things that were notable about this. First of all, the beach was loaded with seaweed. And not just a little bit of seaweed, so much seaweed that you really couldn't pass through it very well. And it kept washing up onto the beach. Now, this happens in cycles. And this is not only a cleansing cycle for the ocean, it's a growth cycle, because that seaweed provides an estuary for the small life, all of the little sea urchins and the sea snails and the sea slugs and, you know, all of the microbes and the plankton and the baby fishes. And yet it will tangle up baby turtles trying to get out to sea. Now, I was also there at a different time of year. So a lot of the animals had already had their babies, but they were still little babies. And the place I stayed at had several types of animals there. They had raccoons and they had coati, which are I would compare them to squirrels in the northern hemisphere. They're sort of day dwellers. They come out, they forage in the morning, they get their breakfast. They were taking their little babies one by one and leading them to where to eat and teaching them, okay? But you can't get close to the mamas. Okay, if you get close to the mamas, they will protect. They will. I had this lesson also, just walking on the beach. I got biffed by not one, but two ravens two separate times. There I was walking and biffed me in the back of the head, warned me off because there must have been a nest nearby. So the feminine side of nature, and that means the natural part of you, will protect, will grow, will create, will expand. And drawing in your divine masculine is how you put that into motion, how you get healthy, how you are able to not only get inspired, but put your inspirations into physical manifestation. You like those words, don't you? Abundance, manifestation, sustainable. A lot of people think sustainable living is going off the grid. And for them, that is how they want to sustain themselves. For a lot of other people, sustainable living means keeping it going and keeping your responsibilities caught up to date. Okay, that means financially, that means health, that means emotionally. That means getting the tender, loving care from where you need it to come from. And if you don't believe me, search yourself. Go inside, feel. When was the last time someone hugged you? When was the last time someone genuinely really cared about you? For some of you, it's been a really long time because it's not just this life. It's been lifetimes. It's been lives of not proper nurturance, not proper nutrition, not proper health care. You deserve it. It's your birthright. You deserve good food. You deserve quality. You don't deserve to live with the vermin. Everything in its place, living peacefully. So whether or not I was encroaching close enough to the nest, okay, and some of you can relate to this even as a human being where you say, hey, there's people interfering with my love nest. They're interfering with my love nest. They're interfering with my man. They're interfering with my woman. There's people sending out pheromones and signals. Okay, and how do you keep what belongs to you, protect it naturally without going into attack mode, without strong defenses? Right here. But some of you are feeling this stricture right here. You're like, oh, I can't breathe. What's happening to me? It's tough. It is a tough feeling, and it might make you feel like you're dying or going to die. And that is another thing with this energy. The feeling of death, the feeling of I will die, or could I die, or should I die? Even as you may be getting rid of suicidal feelings and realizing this is not coming from a place of despair. And these are the dualities that you expel. For example, you have the can't kill yourself anymore, yet I don't want to die. That's a dualistic thing. Should I die? I want to die. I want to die. I want to check out. I want to get out of here. But I really don't want to die. I'm here to do this. Okay? And you got to bring those to the middle. How do you bring it to the middle? I help you with that. We could take another one. Look at what all of this stuff has been stirred up with the masculine, okay? And not that the masculine is only men or the only ones to blame for things that have happened. It's just that things have gotten way out of hand, okay? But let's take another one where you might have the issue of being a father, okay? And on the one hand, you might have deadbeat dads. Those are people that maybe are afraid to take care of their responsibilities. There's fear underlying that. Whether it's financial, emotional, whether they're not sure the child is theirs, whether they never wanted a child to begin with, and they're afraid. And then you have people that have vowed and made agreements and contracts to stay and be committed beyond all reason. Okay? And how do you bring this to the middle? How do you take the fears and take the good stuff and bring it into balance? Okay. How do you get there to twine and be in a balanced mode? Well, there is a way. And so if these are some of the questions you've been asking yourself, if these are the things you are experiencing, invest in yourself and in feeling better, because this class, a four-week class, I'm doing it at my noon. So what that translates to is it's evening in Europe. It's early morning in Australia and Asia. However, even if you don't join live, if you register, you will get the recording. So the last time I did this was in April, and it was very successful. It helped a lot of people get their channels open and get their lives flowing, get their flow back, get their mojo, get the juices going, get their inspirations, get it moving, okay, and connecting with their twin. Now, if you can't make it, what do you do? Well, you do what some of the people did at that time, which was you watch it a day behind. I send you the recording and you watch it a day behind and you keep up, okay? Because this is a 30-day guidance. This is guided from above. Let me ask you another question. How about if you're a healer? Any kind of healer. And by the way, if you touch people and you're a twin flame, you're going to be somewhat of a healer, okay, because you're a natural healer. If you do nails, if you do hair, if you clip people's toenails, if you massage them, okay, and you might be aware of this and you might say, oh, I know I'm doing something extra, which is excellent. But if you know you're doing something extra, you need to be the healed healer. You too need TLC. You too need to be healthy because you're going to other levels here. You're not staying at the drop down. You're not staying there, but you got to get yourself up out of it, okay? Now, if this sounds interesting, I'm doing it from July 9th to August 10th. I also have my pre-recorded webinar to help you, new lives, new timelines. They're on the links below in the description and on my website. My website is www.twinflamesmerge.com. I do reading sessions and webinars. And I have a sort of Shakespearean question for you. Have your cup runneth out? Do you feel like you're just out? Okay, and you want to be out of this? Okay, give yourself one last effort here. Come and join. It is worth a very small investment in yourself for 4 weeks. Okay, this time is a giving of gifts. And with the giving of gifts, this is a gift you give yourself. This is a gift you give your twin, and your twin gives to you. Okay, the giving of gifts has to do with your light body. Now, one last thing. If you do like these updates, please subscribe. We're just a little bit away from showing YouTube that 10,000 people can subscribe to Twin Flame stuff. Because while we might be rather on the small side as a community, we are actually very big in global scale and strategically placed around the world. So, you know, this is on purpose for a reason, because there are people that are helping to wake up the land, do grid work. I'm also going to touch on grid work in this. Have you done your grid work? Have you done some of your homework? Come and find out. Okay, there may be things that you get inspired by within this. I certainly hope to inspire you and empower you. So thank you so much for watching. All the links are below or on my website. And please subscribe. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you have a great weekend, and I hope to see you there. Okay, bye now.